Sometimes I wish I could just do something like plant trees. Just do something that everybody feels totally good about. It's easy to explain. It doesn't require us to get comfortable with so many things that make us uncomfortable. It doesn't require us to cut beautiful trees or to kill beautiful deer or to do anything like that. But here we are in this incredibly important moment. And it requires us to do all this stuff that's really, really hard. For those of us who have spent a lot of time studying forest ecology and wildlife, we can understand how the cutting of a tree, taking a forest from being really clean and neat and tidy to being really messy, how that can be something that's beautiful. But for most people, that's a really difficult thing for them to understand. One thing that's really easy to do as we're managing for wildlife habitat and biodiversity, forest resilience, and all these other things that requires to do things like cut trees, is to just not talk about it. The optics of this stuff is so bad that the easiest thing is just to do it, to know you're doing the right thing, and to never have to explain it to anybody. The problem with that is that if we do that, nobody ever learns about what is actually required to help save the world. What is required to save ourselves and the ecosystems that we rely on and all of their integral and precious pieces and parts. This project here at the Catamount Community Forest is in many ways the opposite of that. So instead of hiding away this really important work that we're doing to take care of our ecosystems, we are putting it front and center in a highly used and highly visible public forest. What I'm doing today is actually putting up educational signage that explains why we did what we did. I know that people are going to come into this area and this work that we did is going to be like incomprehensible. We'll have turned this forest that maybe felt very peaceful into something that maybe feels a little bit more raw or sad or scary or jarring. And when that happens, I want them to have the tools to understand why we did what we did and why it's beautiful. On these signs, there's the tools to download what's called a self-guided tour. So you can scan a QR code, download this free mapping app called Avenza Maps, scan another QR code, download a georeference PDF map, which will allow you to navigate using that free Avenza Maps app. And you can visit each one of these interpretive signs, and each of them will explain a different component of what we are managing for. Things like snags and deadwood, messiness, canopy gaps, explain concepts like ecological forestry and managing for old growth characteristics. This work that we do is incredibly vital. And if we're going to do this at scale and to build public understanding of why this is important and to empower more people to do it, we need to explain what we're doing and why we're doing it in ways that are really, really clear.